come back to that little wooded corner that we have no name for, and I'm gonna blitz my way through all of this, clear out the brambles and what looks like, I don't know, hawthorn, very spiky plant. Cut my way through all of this, just open it out a bit. Well, I'm making progress, but I should come back with the chainsaw and be a bit more thorough. But it does bring out a problem about what to do with stuff. How do you throw things away? How do you clear stuff away? I build up a pile of stuff here. I'm going to burn it here, but I will need to clear all this area so that the fire doesn't spread, as has happened on several occasions in the past. Not with me, but with other people. But as I was clearing away, I found again all the tiles that we took off the roof of the barn up there. And we had nowhere to put them, so we just put them here. I guess the only justification is that it's made of clay and it's going back into the earth eventually. But as I go walking through the woods, I do occasionally come across small piles of rubbish. Now, I don't know whether this is rubbish or an art installation. And over there is an old bucket. And here we have another stack of roof tiles. At least they've been stacked neatly. I was out walking this morning and I came across this plant. The woods are full of them at the moment. It's called Scilla. We don't have bluebells in this country, but this is the closest that we have. It's the same family as the bluebell. And the woods are full of them at the moment. And here is a new discovery for me. It's called Yellow Star of Bethlehem. Now we have another flower called Spiked Star of Bethlehem, which I filmed but later in the year. But this is such a small and discreet flower. I'll have to add it to my list of more than 60 different wild flowers. Look at this, we have yellow anemones, Scilla. We have cyclamen, more cyclamen. White anemones, and here is a snowdrop. All these flowers in just this small area. Quite a cluster of cyclamen here. I have been in these woods for many years, but you can see what happens when a wood is not maintained. But in the middle here, we have a magnificent beech. A couple of hundred years old, I would think. But this is an extraordinary wood, just to look at how the trees grow. Very thin and spindly. There's no management here, other than the occasional cutting down of a few trees for firewood. At least in these woods, which are a little bit away from the village, you're not likely to find any piles of rubbish. Thank you. along this river there used to be many water mills for grinding flour and such. And this building over here used to be one of them. What an extraordinary colour. And just there is where the old town of Svechai used to stand, going back 400, 500, 600 years. From here, it is but a short walk to the house on the site of the old town. A fortified and imposing structure was once perched on a cliff above a bend in the river. Little is visible of the fortress today, just a few lumps of shaped stone scattered in the garden, and a part of one of its corner towers.
Ovo su još dijelovi starog grada Zvečaja. Uglavnom to su ogradni I potporni zidovi koji su ostali od njega. Preostali dio grada je nastradao od zuba vremena urušavanjem, a I ljudi su uzimali njegov građevinski materijal za građenje I vlastiti kuća I kada se gradila ova cesta senjska I kada se gradila pruga, tada se dio materijala uzimao od starog grada Zvečaja, tako da je od njega ostalo jako malo.
Yeah, I do find this an extraordinary landscape. It's like so much of it has been unexplored, untouched, undiscovered. Unlike in England, where you always feel the presence, a human presence. Here, the landscape here feels primordial. So much to explore. Just walking back home, and I encountered one neighbor, Valentina, with her goats out on the pasture, who's carrying on a tradition which is hundreds of years old, where you take your cattle, your goats, to pasture. And she's been killing time by reading and embroidery, which is a tradition that a lot of the young girls used to do when they were out in the field. But it's a wonderful sight to see, and they're coming closer. Little bit of village life. Those goats. What a nice way to end the day.